Hello everyone. In this video we're going to look at what I thought was quite an interesting mechanics problem. And what we've got is a wheel of radius r. I guess it would work equally if we had like a ball or a sphere, but we're going to think of it as a wheel. Radius r, it has a mass of m, and it's encountered a step of height h, all right? And what we're doing is applying a horizontal force of magnitude f, which is acting kind of at the midpoint of the wheel. So it's going through the center of mass of the wheel, this force, all right? And we want to know how big a force do we have to apply in order for this wheel to actually go over the step, okay? So let's think about how to approach this. And you can approach this using torques or moments. I'm gonna kind of think about the forces directly. So the first thing I'm gonna do is just think about which forces we have acting on this wheel. All right, and so we've got this F force, right? The force that we've applied acting horizontally. We're also, of course, if I draw the center of the wheel there, we're also going to have a weight force acting directly downwards, right? And that is going to be of magnitude mg, where g is the gravitational field strength. What other forces are we going to have? Well, we are going to have, at this point of contact with the ground here, there is going to be an upwards force from the ground, which I'm going to call N for normal. Okay, so this is the normal reaction force. This is basically the force that stops it falling through the ground, right? Which kind of balances out the weight under normal circumstances. And we're going to have one more force, right, which is the force that's kind of stopping this wheel from getting over the step, right? So there's going to be a force acting at this point over here where the wheel is in contact with the step. And we're going to ignore friction, which means that the force applied at this point of contact here is actually also going to be acting normally to the surface of the wheel, which means it's going to point towards the center, right? It's going to act along the radius of the wheel because, well, the angle between a tangent and a radius is always 90 degrees. So what we can do is actually draw on a force like this, all right, which acts from this point of contact towards the center. It's acting along a radius, and I'm going to call that force S for step, or it's the force applied by the step. Okay, so we've got four forces, and notice that they're all acting through the center of mass, right? And so to simplify things, I'm going to basically just pretend that the wheel is a particle, right? Because everything's acting through the center of mass, we don't really have to think about like the point of application of these forces. And so we can draw a little simplified diagram over here where I just draw a little dot, right? So I'm imagining all of the mass of this wheel is concentrated at the center of mass in the middle. And let's just draw our force arrows on. So we have our weight acting downwards like this. We've got our normal force N acting upwards, so let me label those. This is mg, that is N. We've got our force F that we've applied horizontally through the center, acting to the right. And then we've got this S force acting something like this, right, up and to the left. So let's label that. And I'm going to say that the angle between this S force and the horizontal is going to be theta. Okay, and we're going to want to know what that theta is eventually. But for now, what I want to do is first imagine that we are pushing against this wheel, but it's not actually going anywhere, right? So we're not pushing hard enough for it to get over the step. So in that case, all the forces are in equilibrium, right? Because nothing's happening, it's not actually moving. So we can consider the equilibrium case where all the forces are balanced. Okay, so let's think about the horizontal forces, right? In equilibrium, if we look just at the horizontal forces, we've got F acting to the right, and there is a horizontal component of S acting to the left, right? So this F has to exactly balance the horizontal component of S in order for the forces to be in equilibrium. So we can write F is S times cos of theta, right, in equilibrium. Okay, so what else can we write? We can consider the vertical forces. So the downwards vertical force is just mg, and acting upwards, we have this n, right? And we also have the vertical component of s, which is s times sine theta, right? So the next thing I want to do is think about, well, how is this equilibrium actually relevant to the idea of the wheel getting over the step? And so what we can actually do is think about like the limiting case where we apply just enough force just to start pushing it over the edge, right? In that case, what's happened is the normal force is going to go to zero, right? If we're applying just enough force to lift it over, over the step, it's kind of just lost contact with the ground, and so that normal force is going to go to zero. And once that has happened, we know that it started moving and it's going to get over the step, right? So what we can basically do is take this n and set it to zero, and that's going to be the condition for the wheel to get over the step. All right, it's kind of similar. You might have seen there's a kind of classic mechanics problem where you have a ball sliding down the edge of a larger sphere, and you've got to figure out the point, well, the angle on the sphere at which the ball is going to leave. And you approach that in the same way. You kind of say it's going to leave when the normal force goes to zero. So if you haven't seen that, you might not know what I'm talking about. So maybe I'm going to go through that in another video at some point. But just to kind of point out that this is a general idea, like if you're interested in the case where something just kind of loses contact with the surface, you can think about the equilibrium and then set the normal force to zero. So let's do that. Let's set our normal force to zero and try to solve this for F. All right. So what we can do is divide these two equations by each other, right? Because then the s's are going to cancel. So if we label these 1 and 2, what I'm going to do is take equation 2, divide it by equation 1, and then what are we going to get? We're going to get mg over f is equal to sine theta over cos theta, which is the same as tan of theta, right? So all we have to do is find what is the tangent of theta, and then we'll be able to rearrange this to get f. Okay, so remembering that S is, acting along a radius, what we can do is draw a little triangle to figure out the value of theta. So actually, I'm going to move this over here so that I can draw another diagram. All right, and so I'm going to draw a line like this, right, which is basically along the direction of S, going from the point of contact on the sphere to the center. And then I'm going to draw two other lines just to make a little right angles triangle. Okay. So hopefully it's going to become clear in a moment why I am actually bothering to do this. Well, the angle theta that we're interested in is going to be this one here. All right. And so what do we know? We know that because the radius of the wheel is r, right, and the height of the step is h, we also know that this distance here, this is going to be r minus h, right? So I'm going to label this side of my triangle r minus h, and I also know that, well, the hypotenuse of this triangle, right, this is just the radius, so I'm going to label that as r. And then from Pythagoras' theorem, we can figure out this other side, right? And so this is going to be the square root of r squared minus r minus h squared, right? That's just applying Pythagoras' theorem. Just a moment, there we go. And so if we expand these brackets, what's going to happen? The r squareds are going to cancel. And this is going to simplify to, we're going to have and h squared minus twice the product, so minus 2rh, right? But in fact, we've got a minus sign in front of the bracket, so the signs are going to be different. So actually, it's going to be the square root of 2rh minus h squared. And then we're gonna factorize this when we write it out below. The point is basically that we've got mg over f. Is, well, what is tan theta? It's the opposite side over the adjacent side, relative to this angle theta. So the opposite side is r minus h, and the adjacent side is this thing that we've just calculated. If I factorize out the h there, we can write that as the square root of h times 2r minus h. Okay, and let me just move this equation slightly so that I have space to write our final expression for f. We can just rearrange this to get f equals mg times square root of h into 2r minus h, all divided by r minus h. Okay, so that's going to be our final expression for the force, the minimum force that we need to apply to push this wheel over the step. One thing to notice about it, right, is that as h tends towards r, the force tends towards infinity, right, which is what you would expect on physical grounds, right, because if you bring your step all the way to this height over here, so that it's at the midpoint of the wheel, you would expect that no matter how hard you push on the wheel, if you're pushing at the midpoint, you're never going to get it over the step, right? And so it does behave kind of physically as we would expect. And so there we go, there's our answer. Hope this has been useful and interesting, and I'll see you again soon to go over some more physics and maths problems.